Did you know that putting on your sunglasses is one of the ways to protect your eyes from cataract? We are talking about ultraviolet rays today, UV rays. Where do they come from? What impact do they have on your health? How can you protect yourself? And our expert today is Dr. Cornelia Baldermann. Welcome, Cornelia.
Hi.
Where do UV rays come from?
UV or ultraviolet radiation is coming from the sun, but also it can be artificially generated, for example, in sunbeds. UV radiation is not perceivable. You can't see that. You can't sense it. So this is very unfortunate because UV radiation is giving us more health effects, negative health effects, for example, in short time, sunburn, you know, or eye inflammation, and for the long term, premature skin aging and skin cancer. Also cancer at the eyes. UV radiation is classified as carcinogenic to humans. Why? Because UV radiation is damaging DNA, and too much UV is damaging too much the cells, so they can't repair this damage again. And therefore, these affected cells can degenerate to cancer cells. The only positive effect of UV radiation is the synthesis of vitamin D in our body. But this has happened simultaneously to the negative effects and before you are sunburned. So be careful about your sun exposure.
So we're going to come back to vitamin D in a minute. Let's first talk about how we can protect ourselves from ultraviolet radiation.
UV protection is very necessary, you heard, because of the skin cancer, for example, and especially for the children. But it's very, very easy. So do it like this. First, avoid UV exposure. Too much UV exposure means seeking shade, using an umbrella, or don't go even outside in the midday time. Secondly, what you can do is to cover you up. So use a bright broad-brimmed hat, use sunglasses for your eyes, as you shared before, use clothes and also shoes so that the body is protected. If there is already unprotected skin, then you can use sunscreen for that.
So what about vitamin D? Aren't we concerned about vitamin D when we take all of these protective measures? Because we are supposed to go out and exercise and walk in the woods and out in the sun, right?
Yeah, this is a good question because vitamin D is very important for our health. But sun protection measures don't mean to block the vitamin D synthesis. It's still running, just in a delayed way. So the main point is go not out in the sun just for getting vitamin D. This is not necessary. There's a pill to treat vitamin D deficiency, but no pill to treat skin cancer.
I have another question for you. I have darker skin, so I have more melatonin. Does that mean that I'm more protected from ultraviolet radiation?
Dark-skinned people like you are not so sensitive to UV radiation as fair-skinned people. The lighter your skin, the earlier you get the UV exposure negative effects. So it's very important that you know your skin. How sun-sensitive is your skin and when it will come to a sunburn? When you know this, with this knowledge, you can already manage your sun exposure and your time outdoors.
How would we know about UV radiation if we can't see it or sense it?
Yeah, this is really a problem, but we have a solution. There is the UV index. This is a scale with whole numbers, starting with 1 to 11 and above. And the higher this number, the intenser the UV radiation is. So it means when you start to get outside, so use, for example, weather apps or something like that, showing you the UV index, or use the SunSmart app showing you your own sun protection times.
Cornelia, explain to us, if we are not in direct sunlight, if we are in shade, are we still exposed to UV radiation?
Yes, shade uses the UV radiation, but it's not blocking the UV radiation total. So it means UV radiation is scattered, and therefore, everywhere you are in shade, you can get burnt, you can get a tan, and also you can get vitamin D. Thus, shade alone doesn't mean 100% UV protection. So go out and be aware of your sun exposure and sun protect yourself. Let me say, this all sounds that it's not allowed to go out in the sun. This is not the case. Of course not. to be in the sun and to be outside, it's very healthy. So go out, enjoy the sun, and do your sun protection very clever, and in the end, avoid sunburn.
Thank you, Cornelia. There you have it. That was Science in 5 today. Until next time then, stay safe, stay healthy, and stick with science.